All right, the Swiss model 1911 carbine, or K11 carbine. Take a look at this model. Now, the Swiss, when it came to carbines, they basically, prior to this model, what they did is they cut down either 1889s or 1896s and turned them into carbines. They shortened the barrels. They got rid of the 12-round magazine because the way they describe it, it was cumbersome. There were problems with it, malfeeding, and also to shoot it in prone position. It was kind of difficult with that long box sticking out. So the Swiss did manufacture two different types, and then they purchased another carbine from Steyr, which some references say it wasn't popular with the troops. I don't know. They're kind of hard to find. And so in 1911, they decided to make a purpose-built carbine. Now, as you can see from this, we have the standard six-shot box magazine. The little pistol grip, like on a rifle, has been added to it. You know, the thinner butt plate. And it is the same action. Okay, they have not changed the action whatsoever. Okay, so safety, operation, everything. Plus it does, with the new mag, heavy hold open after the last shot fired. Okay. Basically all similar stuff. So operating, safety, taking a bolt out, all the same. Now, where the differences come, obviously, you know, the length of the stock and handguards and that are a little bit different. But where it is the rear sight. The rear sight is a little bit different, and it is graduated for the shorter barrel. So the numbers don't go out as far as it does on the rifle. Barrel bands, pretty much similar to the rifle, except I think this one opens differently. And okay, yes, where it's different is you have a sling swivel mounted there and the stock cut out. So this is a bit different than the rifles. Okay, where they have the barrel bands, have the sling swivels there. These do not. Stacking hook. And yes, you can mount a bayonet on there. There's a bayonet lug. Look at the sling swivels here. Okay, the sling arrangement is different. This is set to where the sling runs alongside the rifle, other than underneath, like an infantryman would carry it. This was to be slung across your back. So riding a bicycle, mounted troops, cavalry, it has a different sling arrangement here, other than the rifle. And like I said, sights. So our sights are graduated different, but similar, just like a shorter sight as compared to with the rifle. Now also, what's unique is the front sight. The front sight is mounted with these protective ears, okay? And because of that, if you look, they're solid. There's no way, like a lot of guns like this, will have a way, a hollowed out section here, or cut out to where you can drift the front sight blade. Well, the Swiss approach this problem differently. And what they do is they have a diagonally cut slot, and the front sight blade is driven forward or backward, and that adjusts your windage. In other words, you tap it forward, it moves the front sight to the right. You tap it backwards, it moves it to the left. That's how your windage is adjusted. So it's kind of unique. It's all cut out, the dovetail's cut out at an angle. So that's how you would drift or remove the front sight, is drive it forward or backward to get it out of there. And this holds over on all carbine models from that point on. So basically, it's about your differences. Shorter barrel length, different stock configuration, different sling configuration. But it still operates much like the rest of the guns. So if you know how to operate a 1896 or 1896/1900 or the 1911 rifle, they all work the same. Okay, that's one nice thing about it. This particular gun does have some sort of a city logo stamped on it like the other, but it's kind of illegible, you know, you can't really read it. There it comes into focus. Maybe some of you clever guys could figure that out, but kind of beat up. And this one, yeah, it's got a P on there, so it ended up in private hands. Has some interesting markings on the receiver. And that's about it. Alright, so there's a quick overview and how the K11 carbine kind of fits in this whole family of rifles. Neat looking little gun, can't wait to get out and shoot it. Alright guys.